Honorable members, I have a ruling to render. And as I do so, I order Mr. C. Mweetwa MP, Member of Parliament for Choma Central Parliamentary Constituency, to stand by his seat. Honorable members, the House will recall that on Tuesday, 25th February 2020, when Honorable O.P. Mwansa MP, Minister in the Office of the Vice President, was rendering a ministerial statement, and Mr. M. Jere, Member of Parliament for Livingstone, Parliamentary constituency, was about to ask a follow-up question, Honorable J. Kapata MP raised the following point of order, and I quote, "Sir, after the Vice President's question time on Friday, Honorable Mweetwa decided to go to Diamond TV's Costa program and attacked Her Honor, the Vice President, regarding an answer she gave in response to a question asked by another Member of Parliament. Honorable Mweetwa wrote on that Honorable Member's question to attack Her Honor, the Vice President, in the media. Is it therefore in order to attack Her Honor, the Vice President, by calling her shallow and shameful for linking gas attacks to regime change? Sir, I need your ruling, and I'm going to lay the paper on the table." End of quote. Honorable members, in my immediate response, I reserved my ruling in order to familiarize myself with the alleged publication and also reflect on the matter. I've since studied the matter, and I'm now ready to render my ruling. The point of order raises the issue of a member attacking another member's freedom of speech and debate outside the House. Honorable members, the freedom of speech and debate in the House is a fundamental privilege guaranteed to members of Parliament under our law and parliamentary practice and procedure. The following authorities attest to the preceding propositions. First, Section 3 of the National Assembly Powers and Privileges Act, Chapter 12 of the Laws of Zambia, provides as follows, and I quote, "There shall be freedom of speech and debate in the Assembly. Such freedom of speech and debate shall not be liable to be questioned in any court or place outside the Assembly." Second, Erskine May on Parliamentary Practice, 24th edition, states at page 222 as follows, and I quote, "Subject to the rules of order in debate, a member may state whatever he thinks fit in debate, however offensive it may be to the feelings or injurious to the character of individuals, and is protected by parliamentary privilege from any action for defamation as well as from any other question or molestation." Third, eminent authors on parliamentary practice and procedure, M.N. Kao and S.L. Shadkar, in their book entitled Practice and Procedure of Parliament, 7th edition, state as follows, at page 304, and I quote, "It is a breach of privilege and contempt of the House to make speeches or to print or publish any libels reflecting on the character or proceedings of the House or its committees or any member of the House for or relating to his character or conduct as a member of Parliament. Speeches and writings reflecting on the House or its committees or members are punished by the House as a contempt on the principle that such acts would tend to obstruct the House's in the performance of their functions by diminishing the respect due to them. End of quote. Fourth, Audrey O'Brien and Mark Bosk in the book entitled House of Commons Procedure and Practice, second edition, state at page 108 as follows, and I quote, members are entitled to go about their parliamentary business undisturbed. They are assaulting, menacing, or insulting of any member on account of his behavior during a proceeding in Parliament is a violation of the rights of Parliament. Any form of intimidation of a person for or on account of his behavior during a proceeding in Parliament could amount to contempt. End of quote. Honorable members, in line with parliamentary practice and procedure, and in accordance with the rules of natural justice, the Office of the Clerk of the National Assembly wrote to Mr. Hon Mweetwa, MP, requesting him to state his side of the story on the matter. Further, since the point of order alleged that Mr. Hon Mweetwa, MP, made the alleged statement on the Diamond TV's Costa program on which he featured, the Office of the Clerk wrote to Diamond Television to request for the video recording of the said Costa program. Also, the House may wish to note that the Mass newspaper, edition number 1206, for Tuesday, 25th February 2020, published an article on the said Costa program entitled, and I quote, "Winner Shallow, Shameful, to Link Gas Attacks to Regime Change, - Mweetwa," end of quote. In this article, the following statements were attributed to Mr. Hon Mweetwa, MP. One, UPND Deputy Spokesperson Cornelius Mweetwa says it is shameful and shallow for Vice President Inonge Winner to insinuate that gassers could be agitating for regime change. Two, if anyone is thinking about taking this opportunity because of gassing, saying no, let's change the regime, like the Vice President said on the floor of the House, that no, this gassing, some people want regime change. That was shallow for the Vice President of the country. Shallow and shameful, Mweetwa exclaimed. In this regard, the Office of the Clerk wrote to the Mass newspaper requesting them to confirm whether or not the statements alleged to have been made by Mr. Hon Mweetwa, MP, were correctly attributed to him. Honorable members, in his response to the letter from the Office of the Clerk, Mr. Hon Mweetwa, MP, denied attacking the persona of our Honor, the Vice President, as alleged in the point of order, by calling her shallow and shameful. In his letter of response, it reads as follows. Dear Madam, point of order, by Honorable Jake Kapata, MP, Minister of Lands and Natural Resources. And I quote, I acknowledge receipt of your letter dated 27th instant and not the contents contained therein. I am, however, constrained to give a meaningful and reasoned response to your letter in the absence of a specific charge tabulating the laws that I violated through the statement I'm alleged to have made. I'm fully aware that citizens in our democratic dispensation are permitted to express opinions on statements issued by national leaders, both in the House and outside. I wish to further advise that while the point of order